Okay, so here's what I mean concretely by not doing this thing over here anymore. So here's what I'm proposing we do now. We take all of that data, all of that training data we had, the XY1, XY2, dot, 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 XYN, and we put it in a database.
Aha.
And then next time we get some new X to look at, we just look it up in the database. And we're done. None of this fancy schmancy learning, none of this, you know, producing an appropriate function like, you know, WX plus B or whatever the equation of a line is. None of that fancy stuff anymore. We just stick it in a database. People have written database programs before. We look it up when we're done. We're done. Period.
I feel like you've changed the paradigm.
Yes, I'm a paradigm changer. So what do you think?
It's like it's disruptive. It's going to throw off the markets.
Yeah, it's going to change everything. So what do you think?
Well, I mean, so there's a bunch of really cool things about this idea, which is why I'm excited. So one is it, you know, it doesn't forget, right? So it actually is very reliable, very dependable, right? So if you put in an XY pair and you ask for the X, you're going to get that Y back instead of some kind of, you know, crackpotty smoothed version of it.
Right. So we don't. Yeah, that's a good point. So if we look at this little blue line over here, you'll notice that, say, for this little X over here, we're not going to get back what we put in. So it remembers. It's like an elephant. Good.
So that's kind of cool. Another thing is that there's none of this wasted time, you know, doing learning. It just takes the data and it's very rapidly just puts it in the database. So it's fast.
It's fast. It's like that. I like it when you say nice things about my algorithms. Okay, so it's fast. Anything else you can think of?
Yeah, I could think of one more thing at least, mm-hmm. which is that, like you, it's simple.
That's true. I am simple. I am simple and straightforward. I just need a few things to make me happy.
Bacon.
Bacon. And chocolate.
And, oh, nice.
Have you ever had chocolate-covered bacon?
That seems wrong.
You know, you would think so, but it turns out it's delicious. It's like if you take fat and sugar and you put it together, somehow you like it. I'm not making this up. You can buy chocolate-covered bacon. You're unsurprised to hear in America. Okay, so we've got three good things. It remembers stuff, so, you know, none of this little noisy throwing away information. It's very fast. You just stick it in a database using your favorite database. And looking up is going to be equally as fast. And it's very simple. There's really no interesting learning going on here. So it's the perfect algorithm and we're done.
Okay. I mean, it feels like there's more that we need to say, though.
Like what?
In particular, the way that you wrote this, f of x equals lookup of x. If I give you one of the other points in between, then it will return, you know, no such point found. Which means it's really quite conservative. It's not willing to go out on a limb and say, well, I haven't seen this before, but it ought to be around here. Instead, it just says, I don't know.
Mm. So the downside of remembering is no generalization.
And I guess a similar sort of issue is that when you call it memorization, it reminds me of the issues that we saw with regard to overfitting. So it models the noise exactly. It models exactly what it was given. So it's going to be very sensitive to noise. So it's kind of a yes and no.
So that's a little scary. And it can overfit in a couple of ways, right? It could overfit by believing the data too much. That mm-hmm. is literally believing all of it. And what do you do if you have a couple, speaking of noise, what if you have, you know, a couple of examples that are all the same? So I've got an X shows up multiple times, but each time with a different Y.
Oh, the same X. Ah, yeah. So then lookup would return two different things, and this algorithm or whatever that you've described so far wouldn't commit to either of them, and it would just say, hey, here's both.
Yeah, that seems problematic.
Okay. All right. But I feel like, you know, you're going to tell me how to fix those things, so I wasn't too worried yet.
Yeah, well, there's got to be a nice way of fixing it. I think there's sort of a basic problem here, which is that we're taking this remembering and then looking up a little too literally, right? So I stick in the data and I can get back exactly the data that I got, but I can't get back anything that I don't have. And that seems like something we might be able to overcome if we're just a little bit clever.
Mm.
So let's see if we can be a little bit clever.